To the bill?
To the bill. Colleagues, I will just reiterate, while there might be others who, or agencies that give out our children's information, I'd be in favor of fixing those issues as well. I do not believe the state should be marketing to our children. I don't believe they should be passing out that data to anybody who actually doesn't critically need it. But one of the things that's different with this list is that it is bought frequently. And I would have pulled up the number. Sorry, my technical difficulties with my computer. But I did a public records request of the Secretary of State to find out exactly how many times in the last year that list was sold. And it was sold probably more times than any of the lists that my good friend from Gresham talked about in his testimony. This list was sold to out-of-state marketers. It was sold to individuals. I bought a copy of the list myself. So the fact of it is that this is a high demand list given the fact that it's politically charged and people want that data. And once again, I will just say, I am not comfortable with any database in the state that releases critical information about my child that can be then tagged to any of their social media profiles. And now you have somebody potentially parked out in front of my child's home with that data. Voter file data over the last 12, sorry, Representative Hicks brought this to me. There were 99 requests just from the Secretary of State alone. That doesn't count all the county requests where somebody can just walk in to the Clackamas County and ask them for that list and get just single source county data. But nearly 100 times that list was accessed by God knows who. And I really don't want my child's information publicly available. And to the parents in the room, I'm just going to implore that you think about the ramifications of actually letting that data walk out the door, be sold to anybody who wants to buy it, and then have that information be tagged to your child's photo. You know, their picture. Now we know where they live and we know what they look like. And there's a lot of us who work on some of the human trafficking issues. We know that online cyber stalking is up. Why would we give anybody a tool to cyber stalk our child? I'm not okay with this bill. I appreciate, like I said, the kids in my district who care about democracy and they want to see this go, but we have the opportunity to think about our children's safety, and I would just urge you to be a no vote or refer it back to committee or something that doesn't let our kids' data walk out the door. Thank you.